Hi, I'm Jessica Jackson with Purdue zipTrips. zipTrips are electronic field trips in science education from Purdue University. This is a way for students to connect directly with scientists. Get ready, we're going to give you an inside look at zipTrips.
In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, audio, video, VGR 5. I turned studio monitor down, Jason.
We're coming to you live from Purdue University with our sixth grade broadcast of We're All Animals.
Hello everyone, I'm Jessica, your Purdue zipTrip guide.
And VTR 7, roll it audio, video, VTR 7.
When you see me, the students, scientists, and animals in the studio, you're seeing the end of a year-long adventure in gathering materials, creating a show, developing a website, and creating assessments to find out if we're meeting our goals. On show day, you see a smooth, well-rehearsed program, but behind the scenes, the control room is buzzing with activity. What's really happening is this.
30 seconds.
The live show primarily comes out of one studio, and that studio is based here on campus at Purdue University in the basement of a building.
And when you see Whitey, the horse running on a treadmill, it's like this.
I feel like I'm at a horse race right now.
We're hooked up through fiber to receive that signal back and forth, and the people can talk to each other from the studio to that remote location.
zipTrips is capturing the excitement of video technology, live video technology as well, and bringing that right into the classroom with real day-to-day experiments that we in the university community would be studying. And the beauty of this is that the students can come to the university without leaving their classrooms.
Are you there, Meryl Seidner? Academy, hey guys! The electronic field trip itself is only 45 minutes long, but what you may not know is it takes a large team of people to fully develop a zipTrip.
First of all, thanks for being in our show.
By the day that we do a live broadcast, there's so much work that has gone into the program up to that moment. There are what we call roll-ins that are developed. Those are those little bits, those little pieces that you see that get you from one segment to another.
Hey there, this is Rupert from Survivor, and I just want to tell you, animals are cool.
Yeah! Or it may be a pre-taped segment. But it takes us about a year to get a show fully developed. And on the day of the show, we have all kinds of people working.
You probably have about 15 people if you think about it, because you've got everybody manning a camera. You've got six cameras. There's six people right there. You've got myself directing and pushing the button, switching as we call it in the industry. We've got a couple producers. We've got somebody running teleprompter. We've got somebody making sure the cameras look good. We've got somebody running audio.
So, how did this program get started? Well, Purdue zipTrips is partially funded by the Howard Hughes Medical Institute. And thanks to that funding, the program is free.
Literature shows that in middle school, students start to kind of lose interest in science, particularly girls and minorities. Up until that time in elementary school, students are very interested in science, they're very curious, but something happens when they go to middle school and they start responding to peer pressure and to other things that are going on.
Kids are interested in animals. We can use animals to teach the fundamentals of disease and research. We try to bring important aspects of science into this to teach the students about how we as scientists go about solving problems.
Help us solve an important case using scientific inquiry. zipTrips creators reviewed Indiana and national science education standards and worked with teachers from four different school corporations to develop the programs.
It was a lot of fun to be able to be in on the ground floor and to give our input and to kind of try to help form it to what we would like to see it be.
The teachers bring the ideas of how they want to present materials to their students or what their students need.
It goes along with the curriculum, the one in seventh grade I can speak for anyway, it went along with the curriculum very well.
When you're participating in a zipTrip, have you ever wondered how some of the video clips were created? For example, the video from anatomist Lisa Hilliard's office.
This is Jasmine.
Oh.
Or the zoo.
Koalas, they could go up to 200 plus times a day.
Or the infamous Louis Pasteur video in Disease Detectives.
Hello, everyone. I am Louis Pasteur.
We have three video producers working on zipTrips, and it's our job to work with the teachers and find out how they would like to use the program in their classroom. In the instructional design, we look through the textbooks and the standards, and we try and make sure zipTrips is going to meet what teachers need in the classroom. We also work with the scientists here at Purdue to see what research we think the kids would be interested in and how we could provide it to them in an educational and entertaining way.
So one of the great things about zipTrips for students is that they get to go places through the show and see things and experience things that they might otherwise never get to do. That's also great for us because we're the ones who are providing that. So we're the ones who get to take the camera into a laboratory and see scientists working with mice or dogs. I've been in hip waders out in a swamp watching a scientist search for salamander eggs. We've even done things in the studio where we've done historic recreations of characters like Louis Pasteur. What you might not know is that's not really a paid actor. That's one of our team members here on zipTrips who's sort of putting on the fake beard and the costume. It was a fun day because his beard kept falling off.
We've come a long way.
Now, while there are some pre-produced videos in the show, the main centerpiece is a live location outside of the studio, like the horse treadmill lab. I wonder what things are like over there on show day.
It's very loud. First of all, you know, the treadmill makes a lot of sound, a lot of noise, and Whitey jumping on it, obviously running on it, you know, adds to the noise level. So it's really difficult. You know, I'm always touching my earpiece, you know, making sure I have some good, you know, sound feedback.
He's trotting like this.
We had mainly two cameras, you know, one in the front, one on the side, and then, you know, a couple lights around.
Let's go.
Go, Whitey!
I personally did think it was cool because I didn't know they made treadmills that could hold a horse.
One of the most exciting things about zipTrips is we introduce students to cutting-edge science in real time. If you think of any questions during the show, write them down and have your teacher or an adult in your classroom email the question into the address at the bottom of the screen. We have staff in the control room checking the zipTrips email. From there, they run those questions down a set of stairs to the studio and hand them to me, where we try to answer as many questions as we can. And the next question comes from Benton Central.
That is a pretty exciting opportunity for us as scientists to be able to show how science to us is fun. We enjoy scientists. We don't come to work, we come to fun. We come to have fun. And we want students to see that.
There's so much more to zipTrips than just the live show. You can log into our website to find a teacher's guide, information on how to connect to the live show, some lesson plans, and online videos, like the Week of Scientists, featuring a variety of Purdue scientists doing some really cool research.
I'm Elizabeth Pappas, and I am a research hydraulic engineer.
Oftentimes, students have the conception that scientists are all men, they're all kind of middle-aged or older people with funny hair, and they all work in laboratories. But in fact, scientists can be women, they can be minorities, they can work in labs or out in the field.
So, how do we know if zipTrips have any impact on students? Well, we've got some people working on that too.
We have our students draw scientists before they participate in our program, and then again afterwards. And when we look at that, we see that our students really are moving from a very traditional stereotyped view of scientists as those wacky, crazy men to a much broader perception of scientists as people who come from all different genders and ethnicities.
I guess when I was younger, you know, I thought scientists like had the big hair and the white jackets. But it showed you that scientists are pretty much people, kind of like everyday people.
Coming out of the last segment.
From the students, to the scientists, to the team working behind the scenes, we've just given you an inside look at this exciting educational program.
Doing zipTrip with the students is a really great opportunity to not lose a full school day to a field trip. It's nice to be able to stay on location, not have the expense and the time involved.
That's a lot of work to bring you an exciting adventure in science.
Why don't you come along with us on our next zip trip?